प्लीज बी रेडी फॉर एडिक्टेशन ऑफ पार्ट टू ऑफ ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 123 बिगिनिंग फ्रॉम वर्ड 515 ऑनवर्ड्स 5 seconds स्टार्ट. यू कैन नॉट एक्सपेक्ट दोज पीपल हु आर नॉट गेटिंग 2 square meals a day, whose children go without education and other elementary necessities of life, to go on saving in an uncertain provident fund by undergoing all manner of denials at present. You cannot expect such a thing. Therefore, it is not a question of saving on the part of the workers. That money which you give him is invested in other sectors of economy by way of increased consumption, which stimulates your industrial production. But we are saying, do not keep the gap. If that gap has to be filled, get the money from the capitalist class, the class which is in a position to save, by adopting such a policy, there will be a lot of savings. Savings takes place not at the cost of the worker, not at the cost of contraction of the whole market, not by stifling the stimulants that are required for the industrial expansion in the economy as a whole. Savings takes place on the basis of those who are in a position to save. All that money which would have been otherwise spent, left in the hands of the capitalist class for unproductive purposes, in importing race horses and perfumes and all manner of things, would be available for being spent on clothes, books, medicines and other things which are essential for the vitality of the community and for its healthy growth. Therefore, from any angle that you judge, this measure is a very good measure, and I think the Honorable Deputy Minister would not mind accepting it. He is somewhat allergic to me and to the communist benches generally. I am very sorry for it if we caused this kind of allergy to anybody. But he need not be allergic to us in this matter at all. We have followed some of the state's objectives in the second 5-year plan. Pronounced objectives in the second 5-year plan in formulating and presenting this bill to this house. We would not have done it had we thought that this is such a fundamental thing that he would never accept it, that this is something which is not at all within your domain. We think the honorable members of the Congress party can accept it. We read their speeches. We also read the deliberations of their various party meetings and sessions. We read some of their publications, and we are, of course, surprised at the declarations that they make from time to time. We take note of them. We take a serious view. We attach great importance to them. Stop.